3 seconds remain in the 1980 Holiday Bowl. The Brigham Young Cougars have scored 14 points in 2 minutes and now attempt to complete an amazing comeback.
No time on the clock. It's up in the air. It is deep. It is what? He caught it!
Clay Brown's touchdown reception gives BYU an unforgettable victory in the highest scoring bowl game ever played. Now, 1 year later, a bruised but unbowed Jim McMahon leads his teammate back to San Diego Jack Murphy Stadium. The Cougars of Coach Lavelle Edwards will face another group of Cougars tonight, Pac-10 powerhouse Washington State. It's a classic matchup, but some say that this game cannot possibly approach last year's. They are wrong. The Holiday Bowl is never dull, and first quarter action saw BYU move the football in rather unorthodox fashion. If Washington State found this play unusual, they had an even bigger surprise in store. On the sideline, the great-great-great-great-grandson of Brigham Young was warming up. Steve Young was the reserve quarterback, but on this play, he lined up at tailback. On the very next play, McMahon found veteran Danny Plater, and the Cougars led the Cougars 7-0. If Washington State found all of this a bit confusing, it would only get worse, because the BYU aerial circus was just warming up. Brigham Young had been a party to the first three Holiday Bowls and was determined to avoid the traumatic last-second finishes that had characterized each contest. The nation's finest passing attack plan to put this one away early. While McMahon and company were dazzling the sellout crowd, the BYU defense was making a shambles of the Washington State game plan. On both sides of the football, the Brigham Young Cougars were turning the 1981 Holiday Bowl into a rout. Just when things looked darkest, the white-clad defenders came alive. A block punt restored life to a frustrated football team, and a Ricky Turner touchdown gave the red and gray their only points of the half.
Ricky Turner, deep, 3 yards.
However, the reversal would be all too brief. 3 plays into the third quarter, a Tom Holmoe interception effectively ended the football game, leading 31-7. The Brigham Young Cougars could relax and savor an impressive victory. This game was history. But now, something odd begins to happen. Washington State's Jim Walden can feel it, and so can the 52,000 fans who remain glued to their seats. Because this is the Holiday Bowl, and nothing is ever as it seems. Almost perceptibly, the winds of fortune begin to change direction. Slowly but surely, the momentum begins to shift. A cleat Casper to Pat Beach Aerial is good for 2 points, and the margin is narrowed to 16. The Cougars are back on their feet. Wazoo is now primed to explode, and quarterback Ricky Turner provides the spark. When Brigham Young looks at the scoreboard, they are dumbstruck. It can't happen to us, but it has happened, and the once insurmountable lead erodes under a sea of white jerseys. Through it all, Edwards remains stoic. He has an All-American quarterback, directing an offense that thrives on pressure. And there is no shortage of pressure. Just like that, BYU is out of a big hole. And just like that, they are threatening. Back-to-back receptions by Gordon Hudson end the third period. And the first play of the fourth quarter completes a stunning drive. Once again, Washington State is afforded an opportunity to roll over. And once again, they refuse. Touchdown cuts the gap to 4, and Ricky Turner adds the 2-point conversion. Suddenly, the BYU offensive juggernaut grinds to a halt. 4 minutes left. Third down and 5. Washington State will get the ball with 3 minutes remaining. The Brigham Young defense faces the ultimate test. When Cleet Casper goes down for a big loss, State must give up the football. 2 minutes left. Two downs net 8 yards, setting the stage for the play of the game. Third down, 2 yards to go. A first down means an almost certain BYU victory. A turnover, almost certain defeat. So it ended. 76 points, 52,000 exhausted fans, 2 great teams, and 1 bounce of a ball. Unbelievable? Of course. Impossible? Always. It's the Holiday Bowl, and there's nothing else like it. And even the old coach can smile about that.